Hi everyone, Radhe Radhe. This is a very interesting verse. This is chapter 10, verse 6. And I have listened to a lot of lectures. I have not completed that series on cosmology. So when I first saw this, there is a person here who speaks on cosmology. There is a person who lives in Seattle and who knows a lot about so much. My goodness. He's amazing. So he had, I think, a 6-part series on cosmology. And in the beginning, I was just like, I ignored it. I saw that he's doing that. And I didn't really think much of it because for somehow in my mind, I associated cosmology with astrology. And I was like, I'm not into all of that. So I just let it be. And then somebody told me that it comes from Srimad Bhagavatam and that it's like, I think, cantos 2 to 5 or so. I might be totally getting it wrong, but like the earlier cantos talk about this, and it is basically how the world is organized. So we think whatever we think in the scientific world about the universes and the sun and the moon and all of that, the Vedas have a completely, not Vedas, Srimad Bhagavatam, I don't, probably the Vedas also, but Srimad Bhagavatam has a completely different viewpoint of how things are. And so I listened to that. I didn't finish it, but I listened to, I think, 4 lectures or something. It was mind-blowing just to know what it is. I'm not claiming to know, you know, whether science is right or they are right or whatever. I'm not going into that at all. It is completely different, you know. It is, and what they were saying is that the calculations that they have, astrological calculations that they have, scientific calculations basically on when the eclipses are going to be, those are correct. So that is their claim, that that's why all of this is correct, because we are able to, the scriptural based calculations of all of these are correct. So So he talks about it in the Bhagavad Gita also very, very briefly. So let's go through the verse together and I will explain whatever I can faintly remember. Okay. Maharshaya sapta purve chatvaro manavastatha madbhava manasa jata yesham loka imah prajah. What he's saying is, the 7 great sages and before them the 4 great sages and the Manus come from me, born of my mind, and the living beings populating the various planets descend from them. Okay, so in that cosmology thing, and they explain, both of them explain it to some extent. So in that cosmology thing, it was said that Mahavishnu is the avatar, is the expansion of Krishna, of Bhagavan Sri Krishna, and he, every time he breathes in, all the universes come back through his pores into his body. And along with those universes comes back, they get disintegrated. And along with them, the souls come back along with their karmas. So all of their all of the souls' karmas and the subtle body and everything comes back into the, and the universes get annihilated. They're gone, but the souls remain in Mahavishnu's body. And then when he breathes out, then multiple universes. I think somebody had this thing that there are as many universes as mustard seeds in a bag. I don't know how big the bag is or whatever, but whatever, lots of universes. Every time he breathes out, from the beginning of his breathing out till the end of his breathing out, there is a certain time period. During that time period, universes are created and they're released from his pores. So he's just sleeping or laying down. He's not doing anything. It's just his will that's doing it. You know, it's not like that. The example they give is that Atlas is holding the weight of the world and he's like in pain or whatever. Maharishnu is not doing that. He's just like simply breathing in and breathing out, and just by his will, all of these are being created. Now, one universe is created, and let's say our souls are in that universe. I'm forgetting, this was a while ago, so I'll say as much as I can remember. So that universe is created, and then Brahma is assigned. Brahma is a liberated soul, and he's given 100 years, not human years. It is a huge, huge, like it is, I'm forgetting the exact numbers, but like each Brahma day is, I don't know, 4.3 million human years or something like that. That's just one day, and the one day is 12 hours, one night is 12 hours, so that one full day is that 4.3 million years, I believe, times 2. that's like 8.4 million years, is one Brahma day. And he is ruling this thing for 100 years. And before he rules this for 100 years, then he has to do, like, when he's created. So at the end of his life, at the end of 100 years, he goes back. He's liberated. He's already liberated. This is just a service that he's doing. He does not need to be doing this. So, yeah, he goes. So when he's created, Brahma is created from this whole thing about how he's created. But once he's created, he has to do penances, tapasya, for 1,000 years. His years, not human years. He has to do that just to know, to learn from Bhagavan Sri Krishna how to create the universe. And then he learns it. And then from them, so Brahma is the original creature born out of creature. So Hiranyagarbha is the expansion of Vishnu who creates Brahma. And then from him, okay, so he explains it a little more. So Brahma was born from Hiranyagarbha energy of Vishnu, who is responsible for administering material creation. From Brahma was born four great saints, who are Sanak, Sanandan, Sanat, and Sanatan. They are called the four Kumars. The four Kumars are the eldest children of Brahma, but they are asexual birth from father alone. Brahma does not have a consort. Most other people have a consort. He does not have a consort. He's not born as a child. He's born as an adult straight. And he's alone. So these four children are born not of mother. They have no mother. They are eternally liberated souls and experts in the science of yoga, and they are empowered to help others attain liberation through sadhana. After these four Kumars come the seven sages. These are Mari, Jangiru, whatever he says the names. They are empowered with the task of procreation of human population. And then come 14 Manus. So these Manus, they are empowered for the administration of humankind from the celestial abodes. Now, we are in the era of the seventh Manu. So what these Manus are is one Kalpa is a day of Brahma. That I was saying, 4.3 million years or whatever. Well, that's one kalpa. That is 12 hours, the day, not night, but day. So in that day, there are 14 manvantaras coming from Manu. So we are currently on the seventh Manu, which is called Vaivashvat Manu. So each of these Manus have the four yugas, the Satyug, Treta Yug, Dwapar Yug and Kalyug. Each one of these has all those four, and then the next Manu comes, and then they have all these four, and then the next Manu comes. So we're in the Kalyug of the seven Manvantara. And there are many devtas, so all of these devtas and everyone, of course, comes from the original creator, and he's saying very clearly here, all these seven great sages, the four great saints before them, the 14 Manus, all born from my mind. I don't know if he actually says seven sages and four Purve before them sages, but he doesn't say 14 Manus here specifically. But yeah, we know from the scriptures that there are 14 Manus. So yeah, so that they all come from me. They all born from my mind, and from them all people have descended. They come from me, born of my mind. Okay. That's it for this verse. We'll do chapters 10, verse 7 in the next video. Wish you a day filled with lots and lots of spiritual growth. Keep chanting, keep praying, keep doing obeisances, keep doing all the devotional activities that you can be doing. Keep doing whatever you're doing during the day for the Lord, for Bhagavan Sri Krishna. And wish you lots of spiritual growth. Radhe, Radhe.